Hey! Hope I didn't scare you. Hey, it's Bass Guitar Day. Fender, Jazz Bass, made in the USA. What could go wrong? Oh, it's getting a new pickguard. Black. Black on black. Really black. And new strings and a setup. Should go pretty smooth.
Well, before we do anything, let's just have a peek at how unstraight the neck might be. It looks pretty good. I think it's a little too straight, actually. Yeah, it is. So the truss rod needs to get released. And it's getting a new pick guard anyway, folks. So I'm just going to take that off because, as we know, even though they give you a little, you know, glory hole there to try and stick your thing into, it just don't work, right? They even cut this little ellipse in the body and then they don't match it on the pickguard. This is like the stupidest thing I've come across, but you know. So, with a little bit of love, there we go. That's probably enough. But, as always, we let things sit, you know, till tomorrow and check it again, but that's probably just about right. So let's get these ding-dong strings off it. Oh, this guy has the variable string spacing too, which to me, while I'm dicking with these old strings, come on, you can do it, Davey. That's really where that one wants to be. And jeez, guys, I mean, you can do whatever you like, but does that even look concentric? Perpendicular? Ass backwards? See, I would prefer that, but it really doesn't affect anything if you, you know, once the guitar is set up, I guess what I'm saying is if you want to wiggle these over one or two in any direction, it won't affect anything. It's just variable string space. Okay, you see all that strings in there like that? Don't be that guy. Don't be that guy. I don't know why that one's like that. I got the other ones right. Crazy guys, you the heck.
It even has the retail sticker. You can rent me for 22 a day, 44 a week, or 87 a month. Or you can buy me for 1,480 bucks. I guess. That's Canadian bucks, just so you know, so that's like, you know, $12. I've been asked this before. What do you use to clean a maple fingerboard? Look at the goo on this. This will be much nicer. Guaranteed. That'll dissolve all the shit. She's gonna look just like new, I think, by the time I'm done this. There's absolutely no fret wear on this. There's gunk. Definitely a lot of gunk. Well, that's pretty spanky. Let's get the new strings on it. What's it getting?
It's getting
these guys. Ernie Balsack hybrid slinky bass things. Okay, so we've got the string through option or the pass through the back option. Pass through the back option is somewhat desirable if you want to use flat wound strings. I know there's certain brands of flat wound strings that like to come over that and do the string through thing, but certain brands, they tend to cracks the outer layer of the wrap. So that's, I'm pretty sure that's why they did that. And it's like in the back or through. These guys are definitely long enough to do the string through, and they're round wound, so it don't matter.
Well, that's pretty much it, but you can see we have the William Tell Robin Hood setup. Let's just see what's going on with this.
Okay, so I'm thinking, while I'm stinking, oh, the neck relief is probably really okay at this point, but we're just going to check that. And yes, my feeler gauge is feeling, it's feeling upset, but it's feeling. This is where it all falls apart. I can't even imagine how high the strings are, but I wish I was that high. We have a string action of 864s. How could you play this? How could you even, like, it's so much work that my left hand would be crippled in about an hour. Okay, so we lowered things way down. Way down. What happened? That is almost within the realms of reality. Hallelujah. I hope we hear activity upstairs. Sounds like a rat. Once again, get these. Listen to it. It's like a fucking bowling alley up there. I from the sounds of it, it sounds like 10-pin. Just saying. That's nice. We'll get it. Okay, I'm calling it good, but we got to do some pickup height, which sort of looks okay. But I'm putting a new pickguard on. This will be the only instance where you will see me peel another man's condom, because if I don't, and we install the screws, he's going to have like little niblets of stuff that's going to look like shit. So I will do it.
Yes. Installation time.
I did have a great day yesterday. Got to see. That's a little sharp. Three of my favorite dudes in the world. Scully, Russ Graham, and frickin' Red Shoes. Yeah, it works. Let's just check,
the neck relief again.
Okay, so we're here, and we're down here, and we're here, I like that, I'm not changing it. What's left? Pickup height, instonation. Yeah, because it's Canada now, it's instonation. The whole frickin' country is just hammered on weed. So we're going to send a letter to Fender. It'll be like Sesame Street. What shapes don't match? That shape doesn't match that shape. This will never work, guys. And you keep doing it. And, you know, like, it's like, who's in charge of this shit? We need to find that guy and have a talk with him.
Hey! Let's get that fancy new pick guard on there. What do you think? That's sort of that, isn't it? It's kind of nice. It'll be noisy as shit, though. I'm newly gone. Never mind. I quit. Thanks for hanging out, folks. And once again, thanks for all the support. Special shout out to all my patrons, because you people really do make this go. Please subscribe to the Facebook group. It's fun. Oh, I'm gonna get shit for beating on this guy's bass. If you can't take it, leave it in your mother's bedroom. Cheers, folks. All the shit's below. Thanks for hanging out. And be good to each other.